Congratulations on your purchase of your new RapidFire Pro-LP. We're going to show you a quick video on how to program the unit. You want to do this in a very well-ventilated area, preferably outside. We're going to set up a burn-off program to start, and the unit will smoke quite a bit. That's perfectly normal, it's expected. That's why we want to be in a well-ventilated area. After you complete your burn-off procedure, you'll notice the inside of your kiln's going to basically turn black. Don't worry, that's also normal. After one or two more uses, it will turn back to white. Here is the digital controller you're gonna find on the front of your furnace. Notice you've got four main buttons. Set, this is the button we're gonna use to cycle through the different steps of a program. You've got A/M. This is gonna be the button we use to start and enter a programming mode. Once in a programming mode, we're also going to use this button to control the cursor to change which number we're actually going to be adjusting. Then you'll see you have an up and a down arrow. This is pretty self-explanatory. We're going to use these buttons to change your value either up or down. Your furnace has three modes: run, hold, and stop. It's very rare that you'll ever need to put the furnace into hold mode, but we are going to cycle through run and stop pretty consistently. You're going to change these modes by holding the up or down arrows. If you're in run, you're going to hold the up arrow until you see stop. If you're in stop mode, you're going to hold the down arrow until you see run. The burn-in process that we're going to follow you can find in page 2 of your manual. You want to make sure you set these temperatures exactly as you find them. This is very important for the seasoning of the interior insulation as well as the seating of the heating element itself. If you don't follow these step by step, you may run into issues with your heating element, which could lead to premature failure. We're going to show you how to set the initial burn-off program. These are going to be the same steps you use when you're setting your own programs in the future. Your program is going to consist of a series of C and T codes. Your C values are going to represent temperatures, while your T values actually represent times. Remember, C codes always represent a temperature, and a T value is always going to represent a time. It sounds pretty confusing, but once we show you on our graph here, and we show you how to run through a program, it's going to be pretty simple. Your burn-off schedule is going to look something like this. We're going to have a start temperature. We're going to rise up to our first target temperature, at which point we're going to hold. Then we're going to rise up again to another temperature. We're going to hold there again for a little while. And then when we're all finished, we're going to cool down naturally. The furnace has an embedded code of -121. You're always going to set this as a time value at the end of your program. This code tells the furnace, whenever we get to this step, do not go any further, naturally cool down. The unit's going to continue to light, the fan will continue to spin, but the chamber will not heat any further. Now that you've got the basics of how to operate the unit, we're going to go ahead and start our program. We're going to turn the unit on. So at this point, your unit should be flashing stop. If it's not, we want to hold the up arrow for 2 to 3 seconds until it says stop. You always want to keep the unit in stop mode when you're not in use, because if you put it into run, it's actually going to heat up on you. So to set our first program, we're going to hit our AM button, and that's going to show us C01. This is going to be our first temperature. Now you see this little blinking dot here as well next to these numbers. This is basically your cursor. If you continue to hit the AM button, you can adjust that cursor from right to left. So we can change this value down to a zero. That's 50 degrees. When setting a program, you're always going to have to give your unit a start temperature. We use 50 degrees as standard, but you can always put in ambient temperature as well. We're going to press the set button to move to our first time. Our first time we're going to set is our rate of rise. It's going to be 15 minutes. So let's change this to a 5 here. And then we're going to press the AM button and adjust this to a 15. Now we're at 15 minutes. Now you only have about 8 seconds before you get timed out. So if you get nervous and you have to think for a second, you can always just kind of keep cycling this AM button so you can keep it from timing out on you. If you do end up timing out, it will keep everything stored. You can press your AM button again, and then you can use the set button to cycle right back to the step that you left off. Now we're done with T01, so we're gonna move to our next step, which is gonna be C02. This is our first target temperature. In which case, for this burn-off, we're going to set it to 1200 degrees. So we're going to use the AM button again to move all the way to the left, adjust that to a 1, and we're going to cycle all the way back to the next number, and we're going to change that 1 to a 2. The other way to do it is to hold the up arrow, and it'll scroll. And this is the way I usually teach people how to use these units, because the moving the cursor sometimes is a little too confusing, but then you're stuck sitting here for, you know, 5 minutes trying to get to 1200 degrees. So here we're gonna set it set again, and now we're at T02. This is gonna be a 15 minute burn at 1200 degrees. So we're gonna go ahead and set this here to a 1, bump over, change this to a 5. So now we're done with T02. We're gonna move on to our next target temperature, which is also going to be 1200. We're actually setting up a hold right now, as you saw on the graph. So the start and the end temperature here is gonna be the same. So when you're setting a program, many people get tripped up on how to actually create a hold. Now that we're at 1200, we know we wanna sit there for 15 minutes. To create a hold, we wanna put in a time, but now we're going from point A to point B. Point B also needs to be 1200. From here, we're gonna put in a 15 minute time, but we're also going to end at our next temperature at 1200 degrees. This tells the furnace to stay along this temperature line the entire time. So we'll go ahead and set that to 1200. So now we're gonna press set again. Now we're gonna bump up in temperature again. So we're gonna set a rate of rise of 15 minutes. So we're gonna change this to 15 here, just like that. And then we're gonna press set again to go to our C04, which is gonna be our final target temperature of 1700. So we're actually almost there. So change that to 1, and we're good there. So we're gonna hit set again. This is gonna be a 25 minute burn. So we're gonna set this time here to 25 minutes. So we're at 25. Now our next step is also gonna be the end of our burn-in procedure, which is also gonna end at 1700 degrees. So we're already at 700, so we're just gonna bump the cursor over to the left and change that to a 1. Now that we've set our final temperature, we want to tell the unit that we're at the end of a program. You can have up to 30 steps preset into this controller. And obviously we're only at step 5 at this point. A single C and a single T code make up one step together. If we left the furnace like this and we started that burn off, it's gonna run through step 5 and it's gonna wanna go on to step 6. So what we can do to stop that from happening is there's a embedded code that we can put in the program of -121. That's always going to be at a time. So it's always gonna be a T code. You can set it to -121. And basically that will tell the furnace when it gets to that step, that's the end of the program. We're at 0, we're gonna set it to -121. So we're gonna go to our value here and we're gonna go down 1. Now we're gonna cycle back over to our where we're gonna set to a 2. Most people wanna hit the up arrow because they're going 0, 1, 2, but remember we're working in negatives, so we've gotta hit the down arrow to get there. And then we'll go back over to our, and we're gonna go down from 0 to -1. So now we're set at -121. That's actually the end of our burn off procedure, so we'll just go ahead and let that time out. You do not have to hit any buttons at this point. You're just gonna let the unit time out. Now everything we put in is already stored. So if we were to go back into our program and cycle through the set buttons, we'll see all of our 1200 degree, our 15, our 1200 degree hold, 15 minute rate of rise to 1700. Then we have a 25 minute hold and we're gonna end at 1700. And then you'll see our -121. So all of that will stay stored. If you set it to anything other than -121, it's gonna throw the furnace off because at that point it's thinking that you want a time of -100 and let's say 20 minutes.
What?
Which is impossible. And if you set it as a C code, -121, the unit, instead of thinking it's the end of a program, it's gonna actually try to cool the unit down to -121 degrees. That's impossible, it won't go below room temperature. But for the sake of your program and keeping everything operating the way you want it, always do it as a time and make sure it's always exactly -121. So we've got our program entered. We've gone back through and made sure every step is exactly the way we need it to be set. The unit is still in stop mode and now we're ready to run our burn off. So we're actually going to switch it from stop to run. We're gonna do that by holding the down arrow. Once you see run, you can let go and the unit will continue to run. From this point, you're gonna see your set value in green at the bottom start to rise, and the red value at the top will start to follow it as it runs through its program. So your SV, your green temperature on the bottom, that's the set value from our program. This is the rate of rise that the unit is running at. The red number on the top is the actual temperature inside the chamber. When you're done operating your unit, you wanna make sure you always put it into stop mode before you turn the unit off. This way, when you turn the unit back on the next time, it's still in stop mode. If you leave your unit in run mode, the next time you turn it on, it's gonna start running your last program again. Now that you've read through your manual completely and you've watched this video, if you still have any questions or concerns, please do not hesitate to call us at 1-855-298-7627. We'd rather answer any questions you might have before you try to operate your furnace. Thanks again for purchasing your TableTop RapidFire Pro-LP. Please let us know if you have any questions before operating your unit. Any of our representatives here are happy to help.